Hi, family, welcome back. So today we're going to make a dress. So how to take the measurements? We're going to use this fabric, this beautiful fabric. So to know the measurements we're going to take, so I'm going to measure, check here, just fold it that way, make the sides to be like that. Then I'll just take which I know is going to be enough for the half length I want. Okay, this is 22, so like that. So for the, it's going to be enough for the length. Okay, so for the for the body measurements, so we're going to divide the body measurements into two, which we're doing with we're working with 41. So 41 divided by 2, that would be 21.1. So I'll just measure 21 here. Okay, then half. Add 10 inches to it. Okay, and that is all we need. So I'm going to cut it out. So I'll cut it out. I'll measure it. I want it to be straight. So I'll just paste it. Just measure that. Okay. So I've measured the line. So I'll just cut it out. So that is what we need. And we cannot even use all because of the length. I'm going to place this aside. So for the, for this, I'm using 2 yards and 10 inches. Okay, so now I'm going to open up. So what I need is the length. The half length we're working with is 17.5. So I just added 1 inch to it. Okay, so I'm going to cut. I want to cut this out because we don't need it. So then just add 1 inch to the half length. That is it. So now we have one for the front and one for the back. Okay, so for the front, yeah. Okay, so now let's start. I'm going to measure the shoulder divided by 2 for the back. Okay. Okay, so from there I'm going to come down by 1 inch. Okay, so from there, okay, from here we can now start our measurements. So from shoulder to nipple point is 11.5. Okay, from shoulder to under bust is 15.5. Okay. And from there to waist is 17.5. Okay, so I'm going to just measure 1 inch here. The reason that we have more is because of here. I don't want the line, so just measure one inch. Okay, which is here, exactly the length. Okay. So we're going to extend the lines. I know we know this by now. Now we have so many methods to get the upper part. Okay. So many methods. And I know more are still coming. Okay, so like that. Okay, so from this point, I'm just going to go up by 2 inch, by 2 inches. So just connect. So have, and the hammer I'm working with is 17. So if you multiply this, this is 8.5, multiply by 2. Okay, you can have 17. 8.5 multiplied by 2, that's 17. So that is that. I'm just using 2 short because I don't know if it, this one is clear or the pink one. So now from there, here, I'm going to mark an like 0.5. Okay, just mark it that way, just leave it that way for now. Then half of this is 8.5, so half of it will be 4 plus 25, 4.25. So go in by half an inch here. Okay. And here I'm going to place the bust measurement, which is 41 divided by 4, 10.25. Okay. So I'm just going to connect this line like this. Okay, like that. So here now I'll place the nipple to nipple, which is 9. Okay, so I'm going to add half an inch to it here. Okay, so I will not add anything to it here, which is 4.5 exactly. Okay, I've done this so many times. Okay, 4.5, then we're just going to connect. Okay, connect that way. So I taught us how to get this, which is our bust divided by 20. Okay, to get this. So if the bust is big, is small, it's easy for you to get this side. Okay, so I'm going to measure this like this, and I have 10, so I will just find the half, which is here. So I'm just going to connect. Okay, just that way. So I'm going to, when you divide 41 by 20, it's around 2.05. So you can use just that 2, which is okay. Or 2, just come in. It's okay as well. Like 1, 2.21. I don't know how we can calculate that. So just like this. So from here, you can come down by 0.75. Okay, just make it curve, create space for the bust. Okay, like that. And for here, yeah, the bust that way. So for, okay, we got that. Okay, so from here you can come go up to by 0.75. Okay, which is here. So remember we have 2 inches here, or you can take 1.5 or 2 inches. So I'll just go up and place the 1 inch there, then another one down. So now I will connect it to this line here. Okay, then connect like that. Okay, so we're going to cut off the side and use this as well. Okay, so we're going to cut off this side and this side. Okay, so now we can now, so from here, remember we used 2 inches here. So we're going to just place your tape up this way and extend it by 2 inches. Okay, there. So I'm going to extend this two by 2 inches. If you use 1 inch, you extend by 1 inch. If you use 2 inch, you extend by 2 inches. Okay, so we have new armhole for here. Okay, so this side now is open. Right here, they're open. Okay, so now for the neck, depend on how you want the neck. Do you want it in four corner, in round shape, whatsoever you want it, you can just go ahead and do your. So I will make my 3 by 4.5. Okay, depends on how you want yours. Okay, so then I'll just make a cuff here. Okay, so from here I'm going to remember we have 1 inch here, so I said we should mark it 1. So we're going to use connect to the first 0.5. Okay, so that is what we're going to use. So this will be our sewing allowance there. Okay, so we can now place our measurements here. So here is 10.25, which is 41 divided by 4, 10.21 plus. I'm going to have 3 inches. You can use 2 inches, but mine, I'm going to use 3 inches. Okay, so from here, that is for the bust, and for the underbust is 8.25, and 8.25 divided by 4. So plus this 2.05 for 2 inches, okay, plus my 3 inches. Okay, that is how I want my 3 inches. You can use anything you want for yours. And for here, is 9.5, which is 38. Okay, so I'm going to have the 2 inches, then with 3 inches. Okay, so it's going to be like this. So this is the other one, say. Just connect. Okay, so see. So if you cannot see, I will just use this to trace everything again. Okay. So connect and shut. Yeah. So like this. Alright. So for the downside here, I will just go up by 1 inch. Yes, just connect to this line. Okay, like that. Can I use this as well? Okay, just 1 inch at the down, then connect to this line. So I think we are done. We can cut it out now. This is the post down. Don't make it too sharp. Okay, so this is what we have there. So we use this to cut the lining. So for the back, first of all, we measure the, take out the like 2 inches, 1.5, depends on how you want yours. This is 1.5, and use 2 inches. It's just for the zipper allowance. I'm just taking out, marking out. And you can mark it at this side too. But this side is convenient because we're going to open it up. It's not like the front. Okay. That way. Okay. So from there, we can just place the measurements. The shoulder we're working with or the back is 8. Come down by 1 inch and divide the back by 0.5, 0.5. Okay, so yeah. So place the measurements. We don't need nipple to shoulder to nipple points. So we need to underbust and to waist. You can mark it actually. It is 11.5. Then so yeah, it's 17.5. The length plus 1 inches. Okay, so just extend it. So from there we can, like the way we did for the first one, which is 8.5. Okay, I will see. Okay. So just place your measurements from the zipper allowance and just mark the height for you to be accurate. Okay, so just connect that way. So that is for our armhole. I'm going to place the measurements, which is 10.25, like that. 10.25. Okay, so there's no need to go in half an inch, just connect that way to that side. Okay, so I'm just going to measure this from here. We should have about maybe not 10. I think it's around 9. Okay, let's use 10. So here, and that is the middle way half. Which is 5. So I'm going to go up here by 1.5. Okay, so this is what we're going to use. 1.5 here, just note that. So we're going to place all the measurements. the nipple, exactly the measurement we put to nipple, 4.5. Okay, 4.5. For everything just straight, then we connect it here. Just yeah, just connect to that side. So you determine what you want to use your neck. The front we use it to use 3x3, and for the back you can go back, go down, you can come up, play with your back and play with your clothes as you like. So here I will do the same thing, 3x3. It's okay by me. So I'll just make a cuff here. Okay. So that is it. You can fold here the 1.5 inside like that. Then place our measurements, which is so here I'm going to go up by 2 inches like we did for the front. 2 inches. Okay, then place the 2 inches here as well. Okay. 2 inches. Okay. Yeah. So I'm going to connect, make another armhole. Okay, connect like that. So place the measurements. Which is bust is 41 divided by 4, 10.25. Like the front, I use 3 inches, so I'm going to use the same. I can always trim off when I want. So the down is 8.25, the under bust. Okay, so I'm going to mark 3. There's no. Okay. We're not having any shape here for the fronts for the breast. This is back. So here the waist is 9.5, which is 38 plus 3 inches. Okay, so just connect these lines. You can see. So I'm going to use this to stress everything again for us to see. I don't know why it's not showing. And if I use blue shock, I don't know how it should be as well. So I'm using white and pink. I don't know why it's not showing. Okay. Also, sorry about that. And this is the neck. Okay. I'm just going to cut it out. So the 1 inch here, because even some people they measure back separately, which is always short. Okay, she's always shorter than the front. So I'm just going to remove this allowance. Even sometimes if the front is 18, if the half length is 18 for the front, the back might be 16 sometimes. Okay, so just open up here. So we're going to use this to cut the the lining. Then I'll be back. We'll start sewing. So, oh, sorry about this. And this 0.5, you can connect it to the neck, which sometimes I prefer to use 0.75 or 0.5. Okay. So this is the back. Okay, so I've got the lining. I will let us know. So this is the back here, and this is the front seam. Okay. So here I'm going to. This is the back, the zipper back. I'm going to. You can leave yours. So I'm going to take half an inch from here. So I'm going to take half an inch away from here. Apart from the 1 inch allowance, so I'm taking half inch too. Okay, so from here. Okay, so I'm going to come in here by half an inch. Yeah. Okay. Okay. Half an inch here, just half an inch. So like 1/2 here. So I'm going to take my 1/2, 1.5 here. Okay. So I'm just going to connect to the, I think this is the bust line. That way. So that is for the zipper. So yeah, let's start sewing. Yeah, for the back. Oh, so for the back. You place it this way and sew it first. Then you can flip it over just to turn the neck. And same thing to the other side. Okay, then when you flip it over, or before you flip it over like this, you can sew, then sew like this, sew like this, then notch it here at the neck, then you can flip it over, then you have a smooth side for the boots. That is for the front and for the back with allowance. Okay. Or you can join, it's better to you join the side first, then you can use this, then to turn it the way I said it earlier. Okay, join the side, the both side, then you can after just use this to turn. Okay, so for here too, you can join the side. Sides, okay, then same thing to the lining, and after joining you now use this to turn the neck. Okay, and if you want to put on breast pad, you can cut your breast pad there. Okay, so cut your breast pad, then just fill in